guys over to here. Alright, we had a pretty good trading day. Had a partially rough start to the morning. Was aggressive on our overnight, so I re-entered the pack. So let's go into our trading. Right, lot of members moved around, so. Right, as you know from yesterday's trade plan, we were targeting the 94 entry. We, on the live side, we entered at 88 for the overnights, got the 88, re-entered, got blowout, so that made us break even. We had 94 entry, we got in. Right, over here, looking for the 10 AMV, we suffered through a lot. We got broken, our bigger stops were at 33 or above, so we made sure we didn't get more or less knocked out of the secondary trade. Those were two contracts with 87, you would see the post on top set chunk where I posted more or less what I was looking at on the trade. I was looking at 87.5, 87.5, 82.5, more or less got filled on primary. And we rolled back to right above, stops above there with the secondary and added back one more. Got the secondary at 82, so we got two contracts off there. Very reflected in the account on oil. We more or less pitched it off, looking for that high number at 15. We got the 15, close off some profits early, made some money on that. From the position board, you can see profits and loss. So this is five contracts total, and it is five contracts and two contracts. Based on how you look at how they calculate their contracts a little bit differently. Using two contract entries on the ESA and singles, and two contracts on the single by single on / CL oil. So you can see the movement was new all-time high created, which made us a little bit nervous. At this point, got in there, was more or less by the rumors, the news, actually while the news conference was going on, the market was dipping, got more or less a perfect entry on the 94s here, which stops about here, got our out at 82.5, which was the location we were looking at for exits. And the market bounced right off the 82.5 going into the close. Pretty strong close. This is why delineated here by our short term volume profile, looking at was trying to decide what the volume looked like versus all day at what price. Right, so trading plan for tomorrow. Let's look at our news first. ECB. My time is 1 hour ahead of Eastern time, so if you're referencing Eastern time, 1 hour ahead, so this will be 8:30 AM Eastern. Yeah, I'll see for retail sales and retail sales coming out more than month. Expectation is rise and a rise. Expectation should be met more than likely on that. Not much after that, except some Fed speak and stuff and overnight. Tonight we wouldn't have anything, just other stuff. You can see the draw, the market still went down, didn't want to buy that market at all, was waiting for the reversion back to the upside to get into that short. It's more or less a technical trade, that was a full technical trade. I did that on the live stream, I pointed out that just before shut down the live stream. I'll finish watch that. Alright, let's look at our deviation levels for tomorrow. 77.5 would be our lower end of the mega range area. Wow. That would be just touching on our low for the day. You can see that's a calculation. And we're looking at 3310 for the upper range in case the breakout comes. We're looking at a couple things again later. on, you can see identified nodes, where was the high, where was the new high created, where we closed higher today. So I think this would be not a new all time high, I think the all time high. Don't know, I'd assume might be, yep, it would be the new all time high close. So we create a new all time high close and on closing back on the day. So good for the S&P when it comes to bulls. Let's just make sure and verify that, yeah, it goes higher. It's very vectored over here. So trade plan for overnight until tomorrow. With our 15-minute chart, you can see we're coiling. We're actually really coiling at this height, at this level, left, because we close to the 3000. 3000 would be very, very inflective. You can see the 80 is holding up pretty well. The 280 is holding pretty well. We haven't coiled for the whole week, so at some point we may get news to break out. Today would have been the expectation, is if we had hit 3000, might have gotten the breakout against that. Looking at what we trade in here, may just be still, just work the ranges, look at high low areas, try to get in with edge in the market tomorrow. So I don't really have a call here as yet. Tomorrow morning I see that if you're looking for what is an expected move that we may be fulfilled at some point this week, this so happens that I go and make a move to the upside would carry to the 310 target probably. Just needs to break through to the 3000. So we'll be buying off 77-78 tomorrow. Most likely I'll have set one working on at 78. If we get somewhere float to the downside overnight, and then for the push to the upside, wouldn't be looking to fade the top of this market. This top of this market looking very soft at this point. We have a lot of accumulation happening in this 15 to 20 point range. Once you have accumulation like this, we may be in for another kick to the upside, in my opinion. Just my opinion, don't take this for trading advice. So we're looking to be buyers tomorrow. We'll have a look at value and volume over more or less total section of consolidation, which is swing high, swing low, swing high. This is a value, actual value, where it is. May look to see if we could get a buy, an aggressive buy off of 83s. If we could get an aggressive buy off 83s to 84s, we may look to get the aggressive buy off at that. Look for the upside. We know how much downside we have right beyond that. If you look at 83, you look at the most recent low, if you're looking at buying off 83 or 84s, we would be looking at stops below 77s. So that should fit right into a small trade plan, and we'll have made up so point of support, using point of support as 77 as for our secondary. Looking for the bullish move. With once you know the market is quieting, you can see a lot more time has been spent to the lower level of the consolidation. So if you're looking at the consolidation, look to get the edges of the consolidation and look for the move. You're trading two contracts, be very careful of trading that. So my buy would be off of the point of control right here, using the point of control as the bridge with everything else to work with behind that. So hit single double on the buy side. Now we have four contract trade total, so make sure that you'll get failures, initial failures and stuff, coiling. So be CES Oil. We were looking to be right here within this band, right here for an entry. This is the scene of the crime. Let me just remove all this the data points size. Right, looking at purely structure on the chain. You can see we had a draw today and we still had the big move to the downside. We were looking for that, hunting for that 5840 to get into that short. The market just didn't agree with us. We end up getting the short back when we just took off 20 points, two contracts at 20 points in total. We got in one at 80, one at 1850, took 45 or 46 points off of the trade positions. Yeah, 45 points or something like that, two trades. Alright, so more or less hold on neutral, stands on oil overnight, looking for that, having one contract set at that 5840 level, making sure that we could actually get in just for to not be in a trade but to have a position in the market. This needs to go off. Right, so that's about it for today. Hope you guys had a profitable day no matter which side of the market you're trading high lows like this in consolidation. Trading on this side of it, which is difficult because trading on new all-time highs, trading on this side of it is easier. So just make sure you know where your trade locations are and how much risk you can take. So if you're trading at 84, 6 points are risk. 78, make sure you're trading below your stops here. If you're looking at 82, we say 84, this would be a kill zone here. And of course 3000 is our kill zone. So little bands you're looking at. Not too much looking at this 90 level as yet. Haven't seen enough trading going through that area to make sure that validated. So looking at one entry, secondary entry to the upside of this. Okay guys, hope you had a profitable day. Trade small, trade smart. You guys tomorrow, don't know, might be streaming live for about an hour or so tomorrow to share some ideas. Okay guys, bye.